Unless you're a botanist, or for that matter, a collector of rare books, chances are you haven't heard of the Hortus Malabaricus. Hortus Malabaricus is a 17th century book in 12 volumes with magnificent illustrations of around 740 indigenous plants from the Malabar coast in India. How did this book come to be, and who are the people behind its making? Turns out the main man behind this tome was neither a botanist nor an artist.
I was seeing an Ayurvedic doctor in Holland, where I live. He's the one who actually said to me, "Oh, Renee, do you know about the Hortus Malabaricus?"
This is Renee Ridgway. Renee is a visual artist who chanced upon the Hortus Malabaricus quite by accident when her Ayurveda doctor happened to mention it to her.
In my work as a visual artist, I am very interested in Dutch colonial history through the lens of the other, so to speak, the people who are not indigenous Dutch.
The story of Hortus Malabaricus is quite unlike the usual ones about colonial powers, sagas full of slaughterings and killings, most often for commercial gains. This was about the Dutch shaking hands with the natives, a story of seeking and learning on both sides. And at the center of this was a man named Hendrik van Reed.
He was a member of a noble family in Utrecht. He joined the Dutch East India Company and actually left Holland at a young age.
This is Annema Spudic.
My name is Annema Spudic. I have a PhD in cell and molecular biology from Stanford University, Department of Biological Sciences. And I was an active experimental scientist at Stanford for about 25 years. But I've always been fascinated by traditional medicine of India.
Hendrik van Reed arrived in Cochin as a young man of noble lineage, ready to serve the Dutch East India Company. When he got off the boat, he was utterly taken in by the lush green landscape around him. And there was one more thing that got his attention.
The Dutch, as well as other Europeans, arriving in India, found that their medicines were not very useful in India, partly because, the transit across the oceans, many of the medicines had lost their strength. And in fact, they were mostly all dried plants. And the other thing that he, of course, also wanted to do was to really help out the homeland by documenting and very carefully understanding the medicines in India, because he also notices somewhere in his writings that he found the people of Malabar to be very, very healthy.
Southern India has had a long tradition of folk medical knowledge practiced by the local Vaidyas and based on plants, trees, and spices local to the region. Hendrik's interest was piqued, and he wasn't just thinking of this as an opportunity to up his own health. Europeans had, for quite some time by then, sought to tap into the indigenous knowledge of medicinal and agrarian plants, both as food and as a way to fight unfamiliar tropical diseases, which they probably encountered a lot. Europeans at the time were zipping across the globe in search of riches and new commodities. When Hendrik van Reed decided to catalogue the flora of the Malabar region, he himself perhaps did not know how important his work would become. Here's Renee again.
What is actually the Hortus Malabaricus? Because one can say it's, a translator's, dictionary. It's a medicinal Bible. It has a socio-cultural value. It's the first printing of Konkani Brahmin. It's the first printing of Malayalam. Van Reed was very much onto having what he wanted to get out of the book in making this curiosa.
Van Reed sought the help of the Raja of Cochin. The Raja, only too keen to help, put Van Reed in touch with the local scholars, of whom one in particular, Iti Achudem, was key to putting the book together. The dedications in the book tell us something about the kind of respect that scholars enjoyed at the time, and also about the level of cooperation between the Indians and the Dutch.
This Dutch colonial governor made a book in collaboration with Iti Achudem and Rangabat, Apubat, Vinayaka Pandit, so three Konkani Brahmins, and Iti Achudem is an Araja, so the lower caste.
This is what makes this volume very, very interesting, because it shows that Van Reed and the Raja of Cochin were not restricted by class distinctions, that they honored and valued scholarship and knowledge. And that kind of interaction between Western people and people of India at that time was quite rare.
Although there had been attempts at cataloging flora, in fact, it was quite a popular thing in Europe at the time. Hortus malabaricus was different in a key way.
But in many times, the accurate images were not available because by the time the plants were dried and taken to European collections, and then engravings were made from them, the morphology of the plants were totally distorted. Here, the collections were done in Kerala, and both Kerala artists, perhaps under the guidance of the Dutch and also Dutch artists, were involved in illustrating.
He also made sure that he was doing it well, so he had experts come in, experts of botany at the time in Europe, and he brought it back and he sent, and he had people look at it before it was printed. You know, he was really out to make sure that he had the biggest, baddest book of all the plants, 750 different indigenous species that were mapped.
In the illustrations, plants were identified by their Malayalam names and were then written down in Malayalam, Arabic, Roman and Nagari scripts. Hortus malabaricus was well received in Europe at the time. In fact, it became an important resource on Asian plants for Carl Linnaeus, who worked on botanical classification systems. It was the Hortus malabaricus that introduced several Malayalam plant names into botanical nomenclature. Published in Europe, the book never really made its mark in India. It was kind of reintroduced to Indians by Professor K.S. Manilal. Professor Manilal chanced upon a copy of the Hortus malabaricus as a young student visiting the Forest Research Institute in Dehradun. His fascination led him to a 35-year journey of translating the Hortus malabaricus from Latin to English. Professor Manilal isn't keeping well at the time of the making of this program, so we couldn't speak to him.
I'm a great fan of Professor Manilal, who has done a tremendous amount of work on the Hortus malabaricus. In 2003, Kerala University published his complete translation of the 12 volumes from Latin to English.
Hortus malabaricus is important in several different ways, as a repository of botanical knowledge, a document of the socio-cultural history of the region, and as an example of Indo-Dutch collaboration. Apart from all this, it also holds significance as proof of the existence of centuries-old medical traditions.
These books show that this traditional knowledge has been used for centuries and that, you know, American
right.
companies like Santo can't come in and say, oh, we invented this new plant.
Contemporary science is on a quest to discover new and improved drugs. Hortus malabaricus contains botanical medical information on more than 700 plants of the Malabar region, and this region has a strong history of traditional medicine. Perhaps the time has come to turn the pages of history and look closely in our own backyards for these new therapeutic agents. And all of this courtesy the Hortus malabaricus.